Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Kingdom Fun, and Happy New Year to everyone. Yes, we have started a brand new year. 2021 is gone, and we are now in 2022, and I am excited about this new year. I know that God is going to continue to bless you, my friends. He is going to continue to bless your family. And we are so thankful that we get to share in this new year. Happy New Year again to you. Now, we ended the year studying about baby Jesus. And we reviewed the Bible lesson and we talked about the birth of Jesus. Today, I am going to share with you about Jesus when he was a little boy. He was just a little bit older than you. But before I get into the story, Jesus as a boy, let's review our memory verse. That's from Luke chapter 2, verse 52. Jesus increased in wisdom and knowledge and in favor with God and man. As we go through this lesson today, I want you to think about, what does it mean that Jesus increased in wisdom? Another version of this Bible verse says, and Jesus grew in wisdom, in stature, and in favor with God and man. Before we get into the story, let's have some praise and worship time, okay? We love to praise together and we love to worship together. And we love to sing about the love of Jesus.
Open up the book. Come on now and take a good long look and see God has given us all we need to be free. It's about
Yes, L-O-V-E, love, from the Father up above. We love singing about Jesus. He is so magnificent and he is so wonderful. So now let's get back to our story. When we last talked about Jesus, he was a baby. Now he is growing up a little bit and he is becoming a boy. Do you remember when you were a baby? Of course you may remember some things, probably not a lot of things though. I imagine you have pictures at home and your mom and dad and grandma, grandpa, aunts and uncles and grandparents, they probably like to show you pictures of when you were a baby. When you were a baby, everyone loved you. They loved your cute little cheeks. They loved your smile. And everyone wanted to take care of you. Well, it was the same way when Jesus was born. His mother, his earthly mother, and his earthly father, Mary and Joseph, they enjoyed and they loved taking care of him. And they were always excited to take care of him. And so as he began to grow up, there was a special place that they wanted to take him to after he became a bit older. What are some of the favorite places that you like to go to today? Do you enjoy going to church? Do you enjoy coming to the house of God? Well, Jesus wanted so much to go to the temple in Jerusalem because the temple was his heavenly Father's house. When Jesus was 12 years old, he was now old enough to travel across the desert and travel to the city of Jerusalem and go to the temple. Let's see what Jesus did when he got there.
Come and see Jesus, the Son. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Jesus is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus was born in Bethlehem in a barn because there was no room in the inn for him. After Jesus was born, his mother, Mary,
Hi.
And her husband, Joseph,
Heyo.
Took Jesus to the temple in Jerusalem. There was a man named Simeon who loved God. God has told Simeon that he would meet the Savior before he died. When Mary and Joseph arrived at the temple, Simeon was there.
Oh my.
When Simeon saw Jesus, he took him in his arms and blessed him.
Thank you.
He knew that this was the promised child who would save them all.
It's true.
Mary and Joseph were amazed at his words. There was also a woman named Anna in the temple. When she saw the baby that Simeon was holding and heard all that he had said, she gave thanks to God and told everyone that the Savior had come. When everything had been done as God commanded, Mary and Joseph went home to Nazareth. Jesus grew up. He became strong and filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. Every year, Jesus' parents traveled to Jerusalem for a festival. When Jesus was 12,
come on,
they went just like every other year. But when the festival was over and Mary and Joseph were traveling back home, they realized that Jesus was not with them.
Uh-oh.
Come on!
So they returned to Jerusalem to look for him.
This song is Mary Jesus.
I haven't seen him!
They searched everywhere.
Jesus! Not Jesus.
Jesus!
Jesus!
After 3 days, they found him in the temple. Jesus was sitting among the religious teachers, listening to them and asking them questions.
Jesus!
Hey, Mom.
When Mary and Joseph found him, they said, "Why have you done this? We've been searching for you everywhere." But Jesus said, "Why did you look for me? Didn't you know I would be here in my Father's house?"
Huh?
But his parents didn't understand what he meant. So Jesus left with them.
See you later.
Bye, Jesus.
And came back to Nazareth, where he obeyed them.
Hey.
Here you go.
And he continued to grow in wisdom and favor with God and man.
In that little story, it was very short, but in that little story, we realize that when Jesus was 12 years old, he went to the temple. He wanted to stay there. He did not want to leave. I feel like that sometimes when I'm in the house of God. I love being with other people and singing and praising and dancing and rejoicing and enjoying God. Sometimes it's very difficult to leave. But when Mary and Joseph came and found Jesus, Jesus obeyed his earthly parents and he went back home and he remained home and he listened and he learned and he obeyed and he followed his father's and his mother's instructions. And they were very, very pleased with him. Just like Jesus grew up, you and I, we grow up too. Jesus grew up, you and I grow up. As we grow up, we make choices. And what are those choices, my friends? Those choices are to obey our parents, to obey God, to love God, and to worship him. Jesus pleases God. We can please God too. Now, how can we please God? Think about it. Yes, first we can obey our moms and dads. And then we listen when we are being taught about Jesus and his word. And then there's a very, very special thing that you and I both can do to please God, and that is to sing and worship and pray to God. He is our Heavenly Father, and when we pray, you remember what that means? It means that we're having a conversation with God. Just like I'm talking to you right now, you too can talk to God. And I know you enjoy talking to God with me. So let's take a moment and let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, thank you for sending your son Jesus. And thank you that Jesus grew up. And thank you that he became our love and our sacrifice. And he became our Savior. He saved us because he loves us. Thank you, Jesus, that I can serve you by being obedient to your word, being obedient to my parents. Help me to continue to grow like Jesus grew in wisdom. Dear God, I too want to grow in wisdom, and I want to grow in your favor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, remember, how old was Jesus when he went to the temple for the first time? Yes, he was 12 years old. And was he lost or did he simply stay in the temple to be with his father? Yes, he stayed in the temple and it took 3 days for his family to find him. Now, because of Jesus' love for us, we will never be lost. I want you to have a wonderful week. I want you to enjoy your mom and dad, obey, do the best you can in school, love your family, love your friends, and do something special for someone this week. You think you can do that? I know you can, my friends. And have a wonderful, wonderful week. Bye-bye, loves.